Today, I'm going to go part three. We got one more sermon after this one to finish up. I love my church. And I love my church. I really love my church. And the reason why I love my church is because God loves this church. And so I think you need to love what God loves. Amen. And so today, I want to thank you for being here. Now, I want to get this down in your spirit today. God is doing a mighty, mighty, mighty good work. And the Bible says, I'm going to read this to you. Let this drop down in your spirit because I'm going to set the stage before I preach. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 through 20. Now, I want to read this to you. You don't have to turn. I just want to read it to you. It says, do you not know that your body, listen to this, is the temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, listen to this, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. Listen to this. You are not your own. You have been bought with a price. Therefore, I love this. It says, honor, guard, and protect God, listen to this, with your body. Now, this has got to get in your spirit today. My goal is to make you realize you are the church. We say this, it's almost got into a repetitive thing, but I am the church. And the Bible says that you need to be a gatekeeper. You need to guard the gate of your temple. Now listen, the Holy Ghost is probably going to get about 4 or 5 toes today. That's all right, because we need a good toe stomping sometime, amen? So I want you to receive this in the love of Jesus Christ, but I want you to realize that God has placed something in you called a treasure. It's a treasure. It's valuable. It's something that can't be bought. You've got something in you that's special. That's a treasure. And God, the Bible says, guard it. Protect it. Watch over it. Do what you got to do, but protect it. Protect the treasure in your temple. Now, if you have your Bible, I want you to turn to 1 Chronicles chapter 9. If you don't have your Bible, it's going to be on the big screen. But I'm telling you, the Lord has stirred my spirit, my soul, my heart, all week on this one message. And I'm excited to preach it here today at Elkhorn Baptist Church. If you're a guest, thank you for being here. I'm glad you're here. You're at the right place at the right time. And God's going to do a mighty good work today. Hallelujah. 1 Chronicles chapter 9, verse 22 through 27 is where I'm going to be reading from today. Good to hear your Bibles turn. 1 Chronicles verse 22 down to 27. It says, altogether, those chosen to be a gatekeepers at the threshold were numbered 212. Now, God spoke into my heart, and I really believe that a lot of us, including Elkhorn Baptist Church, are at a threshold moment. Now, I really believe there's two things that are going to happen at Elkhorn. Either Elkhorn's going to step over and go through, or Elkhorn's going to be content where they're at. We are at, y'all watch me, we're at a threshold moment at this church. Threshold moment. So listen to him. He said there were 212 gatekeepers. Everybody say gatekeeper. It's important you get this word. They were registered by the genealogy in their villages. The gatekeepers had been assigned, appointed, watch this, to their positions. Very important you realize this. If you are a leader, you're not just appointed by man. You are appointed by God and assigned by God, anointed by God to guard that position. Listen to me. And of the trust by David and Samuel, watch this, verse 23. They and their descendants were in charge of guarding the gates. They were in charge of guarding the gates of the house of the Lord, the house called the tent. Verse 24, the gatekeepers, watch this, were on four sides, east, west, north, and south. Their brothers in their villages had come from time to time and shared their duties for a 7-day period. Watch this. There was no break. If you give the enemy a half an inch, he's going to take a mile. If you give the enemy this much room in your life, I promise you, he will take you farther than you want to go. He'll make you talk and say things you said you would never say. I promise you, listen to this. For 7 days, they guarded the temple. And here's what God really dropped in my spirit. But the four principal gatekeepers, the ones who were at the north, east, south, and west, guarding the temple, watch what they were doing, were the Levites. And they were entrusted with the responsibilities for the rooms. And watch what it says. The treasuries. The treasuries in the house of God. Last verse, verse 27. When they would spend the night at the station around the house of God. They would spend the night. As a matter of fact, in Seoul, Korea, one of the largest churches in the world, the men of God will come in on a Saturday night. They will stay all night. They will have Holy Communion. They have a prayer service, being ready and prepared for the presence of God to drop in the house of God on a Sunday. May I refer, let's go back to praying. Can I just make a reference point tonight? If you're missing anything in your life, it's because you're not praying. Prayer will usher in the presence of God. Watch this. They stay there all night to guard it because they had to guard it. They had to guard the temple. Had to guard the treasury in the temple. And they had charge, watch this, of the key for the opening of it each morning. I'm going to drop this down in your heart tonight, today, and I want you to get this. The Bible says there were 212 gatekeepers. They were placed around the threshold. Listen to this. Some were stationed at the main gate of the city gate. Some were at the temple gate. Some was at the market gate. Some were over the rooms of the temple, and some had to guard the treasury in the temple. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 that you have something in you called the Holy Spirit that's valuable. It's a treasure, and you got to guard it. You got to protect it. And really what God's speaking into my heart, some of the things that we do in our life, we're not protecting them. We're not protecting the most precious thing in our life, the treasure. There were four guardsmen, day and night, they guarded the temple. I got to get that in your spirit. In other words, they would guard the temple, what was inside the temple. I firmly believe that we're living in a time and a generation where people don't realize what's in them. They're not guarding the Holy Ghost. In other words, they're placing themselves in a place or a position that's making the Holy Spirit feel very uncomfortable. And we're justifying our lifestyles now. We're saying, well, everybody else is doing it. Everybody else is talking like that. Everybody else is going there. But let me tell you something. You've got the Holy Ghost in you. You can't go where everybody else goes. You can't do what everybody else does. You've got something in you that's special and that's a treasure of the Holy Ghost. Whew, my God, it's going to get good. When I read this week, God dropped this word. I'm telling you, I can't get over it. You know, whenever sometimes you just read something, and boy, just spurs you on. It just gives you a good Holy Ghost kick every once in a while. And this week, all this week, I have been consumed with this thought that I've got something in me, a treasure. I never looked at the Holy Ghost like a treasure. I never looked at having a guardsman to watch over the treasure in his heart and in his life. I never looked at it like this. See, the body of Christ must wake up. We must become gatekeepers. We got to wake up and realize that there is an enemy out there called Satan. He's after us. We know John 10:10. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but God comes to give life and life more abundant. We quote it. We quote it all the time. But do you realize the enemy wants the treasure inside of you? And I'm telling you, we got to wake up. I don't want just an ordinary little church service. We've got a treasure in this house today. Look at the person beside and say, you're a treasure. I know you may not want to. You may be mad. You may have walked in mad. But the person sitting beside you is a treasure. They are a gift from the Lord. My goodness. These guardsmen, these gatekeepers, one would stand north, east, south, and west. And I thought about this. I thought about Elkhorn Baptist Church. I thought about my home. I thought about my children. I thought about your children and your grandchildren. These gatekeepers, now I want you to listen to me. These gatekeepers would stand north, east, south, and west. They would put their back to the wall, Donna. And they would stand there on alert and ready for the enemy to try to come in and to steal the treasure. And I just thought about how would it be if men of God and women of God would stand up, put their back toward the wall and say, no, you're not coming in this house. This is God's house. That's my children. That's my babies. That's my grandchildren. Oh, come on. You can do better than that this morning. You better be a gatekeeper. You better be a gatekeeper in this house. You got to put your back against the wall. And you know what? Sometimes you got to fight for what you believe in. If we don't stand up as Christians and fight for Jesus Christ, the world's going to take over the churches. We got to rise up, man of God, woman of God, and you got to declare, I'm a gatekeeper. I'm a gatekeeper. Hallelujah. I'm a gatekeeper. I'm a gatekeeper. I'll be daggone if Satan comes in and steals my destiny. I don't care if Blake is 22 years old. He's my boy. He's my son. And I'm a gatekeeper of Blake. Hallelujah. I'll fight for him. Isaiah chapter 28, verse 6 says these words. Listen to this. Turn the battle to the gate. Listen to me. Isaiah 28, 6. Turn the battle to the gate. And watch what it says. God will strengthen you and will judge your enemy. Are y'all getting this? Thank God to speak to your soul. I'm so fired up about this. I hope you feel what I feel. Listen to me. Guard the gate. Be a gatekeeper. Put your back to the wall. And stand up and fight for what you believe in. Wrong's wrong, right's right. That's the problem. We're a compromising generation. Hear my heart. We justify our lifestyles to fit in. And God made us to stand out. Nowhere in the Bible will you read where the disciples fit in. They were fishing, doing their what they done in their life. And God said, you drop your pole, you drop your life, you die daily, you pick the cross up, and you follow me. You follow me. Christianity's not a joke. It's hot as hell. It's hot sometimes. Sometimes, man, you get put in situations you don't understand. But I'm telling you and declaring today, we as God's people, God's men and God's women and deacons and pastors must rise up and be gatekeepers. That's right. Here's what God told me. I'm going to give this to you. The Bible talks about four gates. Everybody say four gates. Now, I'm going to give them to you real quick. I'm not going to drag it out, but I am going to preach it out. Here's the deal. Four gates. And I want to give you the first gate. Just listen to me. It's very important. It's very careful what enters this first gate I give you. It's called the eye gate. It's called the eye gate. Everybody say eye gate. I've been married to Dana for coming on 20 years. Yeah, but listen. That's why y'all love me, because my wife, I know that. I'm more in love with her today than I was when I met her back in 1994. But here's what I realize in my life, my journey. I know I have to watch and guard and protect my eye gate. And I want to tell the men here today, man to man, preacher to friend, friend to friend. I want to be honest with you just for a moment. You've got to watch. You've got to protect. You've got to guard your eye gate. If you're not careful, Satan will dress up in a bathing suit. And he'll stand up in front of you and, oh, she'll look good. Oh, it's just a little flirtation. It don't matter. Everybody else looks and everybody else does this. I'm not everybody else and you're not either. I'm telling you the truth this morning. You better guard your eye gate. And no man is above reproach of sin, including your pastor. But one thing I'm telling you, Satan, by ordained command, he will plant people in your life to mess up your destiny if you don't guard your eye gate. No man. This is more of an Elkhorn sermon. This is going to be online. So if you're listening today, I'm talking to you too, man of God, driving that car. Pull it off the side of the road, because God's getting ready to tackle you in the Holy Ghost. Here's what I'm telling you is this. Hallelujah. No man needs to be in the car with the opposite sex if it's not his wife. Now listen to me. I'm shooting you straight today. Y'all say, preach, preacher. Yeah, I am. Hallelujah. It's a deal. You got to watch. You got to guard. You got to protect your eye gate. Because I'm telling you, I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about this morning. If you don't protect the eye gate, It'll get down in your heart gate. And I'm telling you, listen to me, if you allow the enemy to come through the eye gate, it'll steal the treasure of God in your life. Come on, it'll steal things that you love. It'll rob you of your joy. It'll rob you of all these things. You watch your eye gate. Watch your eye gate. Because I'm telling you, your eyes lead to your soul. Watch your eye gate. Everybody say, I'm watching my eye gate. Yeah, if you're not careful, here's what's going to happen. The enemy will place things, people, put you in places. I'm telling you, if you don't watch the eye gate, the enemy will come through the eye gate and rob you. He'll rob you. Y'all know I'm preaching. Y'all may not act like it, but I'm preaching. I'm a gatekeeper. Everybody say, I'm a gatekeeper. Come on. I'm a gatekeeper. Over my eyes. I'm going to watch what I watch on TV, amen? I'm going to be careful. I'm going to be careful what I watch on television. I'm going to be careful what I look at in a book. I'm going to be careful. And I know this may be some old-fashioned Pentecostal preaching today, but that's okay. We need some old-fashioned Pentecostal preaching back in the houses of God, amen? You got to watch out what you're watching. You got to guard yourself. Just because you think that she's a sweet little mama, hallelujah, it may not be a sweet little mama. It may be the devil in a dress. Boy, that's some good preaching, Brother Brian. Well, I tell you what. Watch your eye gate. Number two, watch your ear gate. Watch your ear gate. It does matter what you listen to. Yes, it does. It matters what you listen to. Because I am a spirit. I don't care what y'all say. 1 Thessalonians 5 says, I am a spirit. I have a soul, but I live in a body. Whatever spirit you feed is the one's going to come to life. Hallelujah. I am a spirit. It does matter, youth, what you listen to. It does matter what you download on your iPods. It does matter what you're listening to. It'll feed that spirit. If you've got Marilyn Manson, you've got all that stuff on your iPod and cussing, chewing, and doing, and delete. I'm being honest with you. Delete it off or get it away from you. Because listen to me. If the enemy, that's who, if the enemy comes through the ear gate, if the enemy comes through your ear gate, it'll rob you of the treasure of God, of the Holy Ghost that's in your life. Y'all get that? I love y'all, man. Y'all are the generation now. Oh, that's a God thing. He got a generation now shirt on. You do too. We're not waiting to raise them up 30 years from now. We need you now. We need you now. We need moms and dads now. You don't have to be your friend, your child's best friend. They got them at school. Sometimes you got to say no is no, right is right. You're not going there. You're not hanging out with them. And if you don't like it, I'll take you behind the Holy God woodshed. Hey! I'm a gatekeeper. I'm a gatekeeper. On my eyes and my ears, I'm a gatekeeper. I watch that stuff. It is my job. Oh, come on and praise His name. Hallelujah. People on the radio call and say, are y'all really that happy? Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. We got the Word of God in this house and we're not backing down. I am a gatekeeper of my children. Travis Gibbon, I'm a gatekeeper of your life. It's more than just saying I love Travis Gilpin. I got to be his gatekeeper. He's got to be my gatekeeper. You got to have somebody in your life that's going to guard the gate of your life. I feel the Holy Ghost. You got to have somebody that can look at you and say, brother, that's not right. Sister, that's not right. You don't need to talk like that, act like that, go there. Why? Because I'm a gatekeeper. God, I praise you in this house today. God, I thank you for what you're doing in this house right now, Lord. I thank you that you're staring and you're moving. God, you're going to and fro up and down these aisles. Thank you for what you're doing in our youth group, God. They'll never be the same in Jesus' name. God, thank you for the moms and daddies that are rising up and being gatekeepers in this house. God, I thank you that pastors and preachers and teachers and deacons and all are gatekeepers of the house. Lord, I thank you and I declare today, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise. Whew. Golly. Sometimes I can't even hardly stand. You have a treasure in you. I can't afford to give the enemy my treasure. I can't afford just to be a good professional preacher. I can't afford to lose my anointing. I can't afford for the hand of the Lord to just come off my life. I got something in me called the Holy Ghost. I got a treasure in me. I know y'all may not feel this, but this old preacher feels it this morning. I got something in me special. I got a treasure in me. I got to guard that treasure. I can't go and talk and do like I once did. Because if I put the Holy Spirit in a place where he's uncomfortable, the enemy has a chance to come through my eye gate and my ear gate and take my treasure, my anointing. How many pastors have failed? Because they allowed the enemy through the gate. Come on. Good pastors. Good men of God. But you know what happened? Y'all listen to me. They allowed the enemy through the gate. See, a gate can go two ways. You let them in and they come out. And what goes in will eventually come out. Whatever music you're listening to, it eventually flow out of your lips. I have teenagers tell me this all the time. Well, I'm just listening to the music and not the words. That is not what the Bible says. You are a spirit. And whatever spirit you're feeding and connecting to is the one that's going to grow. It is important what you look at. It is important what goes through your eye gate and your ear gate. Y'all help me. So true. See, some of you, I wrote this down, some of you have a problem praising the Lord. I don't think that's the case today. Some of you have a problem praising the Lord. You know why? Because you have allowed the enemy to come through your eye gate and your ear gate. Listen to me. And it has taken, stolen the treasure of joy out of your life. How many of you know some of the most miserable people in the world are Christians? Listen to me. I'm preaching now. Some people who will hurt you the worst is Christians. Can I ask y'all a question? Why? We got a treasure in us. We got the Holy Ghost in us. Greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. And I am a gatekeeper over my eyes and over my ears. There's no reason why I should be mean. And all the babies said, hallelujah. See, y'all think that's crying. I don't. I think it's giving God praise. This sounds weird, but she's speaking in tongues right now. Hallelujah. Only she and God know what's happening right now. You need to make your minds up. Y'all got me? Say, gotcha. I'm almost finished. You need to make your minds up right now that nothing is worth losing your treasure. Nothing is worth losing. Nothing is worth losing your children. Nothing is worth losing your ministry. Nothing is worth losing the treasure of God in your life. Protect the treasure. Hallelujah. Because I'm telling you, the enemy, the devil, is a treasure hunter. Whew. Had to preach. The devil, the enemy, is a treasure hunter. He's wanting to steal what God has placed in you. He's wanting to rob you of your joy, rob you of your family, come between you and your family. He's wanting to steal the treasure. The next one is the mouth gate. Woo! Everybody say, preach this, preacher. You got the eye gate, the ear gate, and the mouth gate. How many of you know words can poison the atmosphere? Words can poison the atmosphere. Life and death is within the power of the tongue. We know that. We quote that. Either you bring life to the atmosphere or you serve a death warrant to the atmosphere. If you don't have nothing good to say at this church, don't say it. remember, the Bible says, I want y'all let this get in your heart. The Bible says all humanity, every male, every female, every youth, every child, one day will stand before the Lord and give an account. Listen to this. Here's what gets deep. On every word that proceeds from your mouth. Mouth. The Bible says be a gatekeeper of the mouth. Last one is a heart gate. Heart gate. Everybody say heart gate. Listen to this. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23 says, above all else. Listen to this. Above all else, guard your heart. For it is the wellspring of life. My heart is the wellspring of life. Psalms 51:10 says, create in me a clean heart and a pure heart. 1 Samuel 13:14 says this. Listen to this good word. God seeks out a man after his heart. God seeks out a man or a woman after his heart. What I'm trying to say today is be a gatekeeper. Be a gatekeeper over your eyes and over your ears, over your mouth, and over your heart. Watch, guard, and protect that gate. Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm a gatekeeper. Listen to me. Praise team, you guys come. I want to say something real quick. Statistics say that 52% of first-time marriages fail. According to Barna Research, close to 60% of second-time marriages fail. And I want to say today, be a gatekeeper of your marriage. Man of God, woman of God, you have no business talking to somebody who's not your spouse about your relationship with your wife or your husband. I know I'm preaching in here because it's like a cricket. Pastor, we got some pastors in here today. Deacons, elders, whomever you are. Here's what I'll tell you. You be a gatekeeper over the temple. You got to put your back to the wall. That means nobody's going to get around you because somebody's watching out for you. Be a gatekeeper of Elkhorn Baptist Church. Not everybody is going to fit in. Not everybody's going to like Elkhorn Baptist Church. Watch this. I don't care. Watch this. God don't care. God is not about a popularity contest. He's about being kingdom-minded.
That's right.
And when we're kingdom-minded, we'll love the way God loves. We'll act the way God acts. We'll talk the way He talks. And I'm telling you today, what we need in churches right now, and this word is going out to 40,000 people right now as I speak this. So listen to me. We need pastors to be gatekeepers over the congregation. We need deacons to rise up. We need daddies and mamas to rise up and put their back to the temple and say, no, you're not doing that no longer. For as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. You can't come through the gate no more. You can't come through my eye gate, my ear gate, my mouth gate, or my heart gate. Can't do it. You've got something in you called a treasure. And that treasure, you got to protect it. Let me ask you something. If you had $100,000 cash in your house, at your home right now, which first of all, I highly request you put it in the bank. But if you had that money in your house, and you knew the enemy was coming, what would you do? If you knew the enemy was coming after your children right now, one of the most valuable treasures in the whole wide world is your babies. And we are allowing the enemy to come through their eye gates and put little things on their ears and not even knowing what they're listening to through iPods. And I know I'm preaching, it's okay. How much more should you love them? Your treasures. Your treasures. My wife. God says you love her the way that you love. I love the church, the temple. And we got so many men backing out and backing down. need to rise up and be the gatekeeper over your wives. Hallelujah. Come on, women. You can say amen to that. We need gatekeepers. We need gatekeepers. So my whole sermon, to sum it up, is this. You've got a treasure in you called the Holy Spirit. You are the temple. And God says you guard the treasure with your body. Put them north, east, south, and west. Don't just hang with anybody because not everybody loves you.
That's right.
Be careful who you allow to speak into your life. Be careful what you watch and listen to. Be a gatekeeper, amen? Be a gatekeeper. And here's what I want to commit to you today as the pastor of this church. I want to be your gatekeeper. I want to be one that will stand at the door and says, no, you will not hurt God's people. You will not come into this house and cause a disruption and chaos and confusion. I'm going to be a gatekeeper over the house of God. So if you would at this time, husbands, wives, pastors, deacons, church members, friends, guests, here's what I want to challenge you with. Those four principal gatekeepers, Jamie, would stand on top of the wall. I love this. They would stand on top of the wall, north, east, south, and west. And they would look over the horizon. Watch me. They would look, and if they seen the enemy coming, they would do two things. They would sound the alarm, and here's what they would yell. Shut the gate. Shut the gate. What if they didn't shut the gate and the enemy was coming? They would all die. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. What I'm declaring today is shut the gate. Shut the gate. You know what's going on in your life. Quit having so much pride in your life that you're going to sit there and die and you're not going to get to spend the treasures of your life. Y'all know it's true. You got treasures in you, Mark. And we would much rather fit in and not embarrass ourselves and not have all the embarrassment, and we'll sit there on our blessed assurance and let the enemy through our eye gate, ear gate, mouth gate, heart gate, and he'll rob the treasure